During the last 2 weeks, a Caribbean volcano produced more earthquakes than it did across a prior two-year time span. The volcano in question produced the deadliest volcanic eruption of the 20th century. What I'm referring to is Mount Pelee on the French island of Martinique, which ever since early April has been the site of an escalating number of seismic events. During this time span, the number of weekly earthquakes has increased from 1 to 30 to 70, but ever since August began, each week has seen more than 100 earthquakes strike. And for the 7-day time span preceding August 22nd, a whopping 655 weekly earthquakes struck. This development is slightly concerning, as for reference, Mount Pelee had been experiencing a weak, longer-term episode of unrest that began in November 2018 when its hydrothermal system seemingly reactivated. Its alert level was subsequently raised to yellow and maintained at that ever since late 2020. Subsequently, increased earthquakes were followed by dead patches of vegetation appearing due to increased carbon dioxide emissions, only for weak uplift to be detected in mid-2022. But then, many of the dying patches of vegetation had new vegetation reappear within them as all signs of unrest subsequently decreased throughout 2023 and 2024. It was only in 2025 that this trend reversed once again, transitioning to an increase in seismic activity, eventually marking 2025 as the year with the highest number of volcanic earthquakes striking underneath Pelee since it last erupted nearly a century ago. In my opinion, something clearly has changed at this potentially dangerous active volcano, but the good news is that at least for now, I do not interpret the change as due to fresh rising magma. The reason relates to the exact type of earthquakes Pelee has been experiencing, with this being a quick reference chart. Not only have the rate of volcano tectonic earthquakes increased, but also the number of long period and hybrid earthquakes. Both of these latter types of earthquakes are largely related to hydrothermal fluid movement, once again reinforcing my suspicion that a change has recently occurred there. However, what was absent were tremor events, which is a good sign since they are often caused by magma movement, with a less such tremor event occurring at Pelee in November 2021. It is true that a change in a volcano's hydrothermal system is often the first sign of volcanic unrest at many world volcanoes, but such changes can also occur intermittently unrelated to signs of actual unrest. Regardless, I think it is worth temporarily increasing monitoring at Mount Pelee, especially keeping an eye on the number of shallow hybrid earthquakes it has recently been producing. Under a very specific set of circumstances, hydrothermal fluids can be heated to sufficient values to generate a non-magmatic volcanic eruption, creating a steam explosion known as a phreatic eruption. While I see no direct evidence of such an imminent threat in my opinion of a phreatic eruption, I am merely highlighting this highly unlikely possibility to emphasize why Pelee's activity needs to continue to be monitored. If anyone decides to also look at Mount Pelee's seismic activity, keep these figures in mind. Most of this activity is occurring in its hydrothermal system, which is located mainly between 1 and 1.5 kilometers beneath its summit. Pelee's main magma chamber is located at 5 to 7.5 kilometers depth, and its magma reservoir at 12 to 16 kilometers depth. The current activity is not yet sufficient to once again increase Pelee's alert level, and there is no reason to panic, but I thought it would be worth sharing its somewhat unexpected increase after multiple years of declining unrest. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, EK, for supporting my work.